If you've already created a few long-form videos, you actually have a lot more content than you think. Today, we're teaching you how to repurpose your video content across all your social media platforms. Editing short-form videos just became easier in PowerDirector with the new portrait preview window option, so stick around until the end to see it. We'll separate this first step into planned versus unplanned content. If you already have some long-form video content, you would fall into the unplanned category. This means that you didn't plan to cut highlights out of your content before making it. So the first thing you're going to do is go through your video and identify the highlights. Depending on the type of content you create, these highlights will look different. If you created a tutorial for, let's say, a video effect, your highlight would be the final effect. If you make tips and tricks videos, you can use the key takeaways in each of your tips and tricks as highlights to create multiple short-form videos. If you fall into the planned content category, you should already know which part or parts you plan to cut out for your short video. Once you've identified the highlights, it's time to trim the fat. Shorts on YouTube have a limited length of 60 seconds, and Reels on Instagram have a limit of 90 seconds. So you have to condense your content to be catchy and concise. When cutting your video, you'll want to trim out anything that'll make your short video unnecessarily long. Cut out any filler words that might come before or after your main points, and trim out any uhs and ums. If you want to see a few examples of highlight videos cut out of long-form content, you can go check out our shorts. The short for this video will be here. Make sure you're subscribed so that you're catching all of our long-form and short-form content. Let's talk about aspect ratio. The aspect ratio for a long-form video is 16:9. That's what you're currently looking at now. When you want to create a short-form video, the aspect ratio becomes 9:16. And if you're creating a thumbnail for your short-form video, the aspect ratio might once again be different. YouTube Shorts and TikTok will both be 9:16. However, Instagram is a bit trickier. The video or reel on Instagram will look different depending on where you view it. On the Reels page on your profile, the aspect ratio will be 9:16. However, if you view it on your profile's main page, it'll be a 1:1 square. In the feed, it'll be 4:5 before tapping in to view it on the full screen, and it'll be 9:16 once you tap into view. Each platform will also have what's called safe zones. Safe zones are the areas of the video that won't have on-screen obstructions, such as the like and comment buttons or the description. That means that anything important for viewers to see, such as captions or subtitles, should be shown inside the parameters of the safe zone on your chosen platform. Each platform will have its own safe zone, so it's best to find the most updated template online and edit your video within the parameters of the template. We'll show you how to do that in a bit. All of these aspect ratios and safe zones might sound really confusing, but the rule of thumb is to try and keep the most important parts of your content in the center of your video. PowerDirector's newest feature, Portrait Preview, will allow you to see your 9:16 short-form video more clearly while editing. Previously in PowerDirector, you could change the aspect ratio, however, the preview window didn't adjust. So in order to edit a 9:16 video, you'd have to either make the preview window bigger and sacrifice the size of the timeline, or edit in a smaller default preview window. All right, let's get editing. Once you've trimmed away the excess and left just your highlight clip, change the aspect ratio from 16:9 to 9:16. Then, to get into the portrait preview, press the layout button, then select portrait. From here, you can adjust the image to fill the entire preview, or you can leave some space at the top and bottom for subtitles and other features, depending on what style you prefer. If you leave space, you can change the color of the background from black to another color using the color boards in the media tab. Just drag and drop it onto the first track and move your resized video onto the second track. For safe zone templates, go into the My Media drop-down menu in the Media tab and click Import. Find your downloaded template and import it into PowerDirector. Drag and drop it onto the overlay track. It'll look like it's covering your main video. From here, highlight the template, then click Edit. Under the Tools drop-down menu, go into Opacity, then scale it down until you see your main video underneath your template. Go over into your timeline and lock the track with your template so that it stays in place while you edit underneath it. When you're done with your video, you can either delete the template clip or scale the opacity down to 0%. Inversely, you can also use your save zone template as a complete starter template by saving it as a PowerDirector script file. This will create an editable file for you to use in all future videos. You can learn how to do this in this tutorial. If you found any of that helpful, give this video a like and let us know in the comments below what you want to see next. See you in the next video.